our friends from Ghana who have qualified for the Multi-Choice Talent Factory. They're going all the way to Nigeria. They're going for a year. Like, I don't envy you, but I'm happy for you guys. You know, they made it out of how many contestants here in Ghana? Do you know?
Yeah, I think there were over 20 or 60.
Okay, 20, 60. Yeah. That's okay. Huge. Okay, so you had some contestants, you know, and you made it. So you're going to introduce yourself to us one after the other. So let's start from you from the very end. What's your name and what are you majoring in?
Okay, my name is Ariyam Akodumebi and I'm majoring in television production and directing.
Okay, and you are?
My name is Edmond Kobi Asamoah and I'm majoring in cinematography, camera work.
And you are?
I'm Henry Katie, cinematographer, director, and set designer.
Madam?
I'm Patience Essiaunam Adiseno, and I'm doing mostly screenwriting and directing.
Screenwriting and directing, but how do you feel about these opportunities? An opportunity for you to go into an incubator, sort of, you're going to be groomed. Like, how does the initiative make you feel?
Okay, so for now, we are kind of expecting to learn more, to add up to what we've already learned in school. That's I attended tech and then my friends are from NAFTI, so we are currently hoping to learn more and then gain more insights on the film industry and also to come up with a bright idea to help push the Ghanaian movie industry.
Thanks for thinking about Ghana. I'm sure you told me same. You know, the Ghanaian movie industry has come under a lot of scrutiny. What do you think that this opportunity that has been given you by Multi-Choice would add to you?
I feel that we have a lot of stories to tell. As a Ghanaian, a lot of things happen around us politically, socially, economically, and culturally. So I think that it will be an opportunity for us to know, to have the technical know-how to produce and tell the Ghanaian story to the rest of the world. And yeah.
How soon are you hoping to tell a story? Now, you are majoring in cinematography, yeah. You're saying, so your work is behind the camera.
Yeah, not so, just behind the camera per se. Directing, a bit of directing, and then much of direction as well.
Okay, yeah. So how soon after the 1 year? Yeah, 1 year, it's just 12 months away.
Sure,
I hear
sure.
You're starting in October, yeah, so yeah. By next October, yeah. You're done. How long afterwards are you hoping to do something that will be of significance to industry here?
Well, you know, when we talk about adoration in film, adoration basically gives you the visual aesthetics of what you're seeing. Mm-hmm. What are you sitting in your home and what is watching on the screens. Everything, every element that is filled in the screen is based on adoration. Mm-hmm. And sometimes we add a bit of lighting to adoration as well. So, To go all the way for a year and then come back, we're hoping to produce something beautiful, something very, very, very magical on the set. Yeah.
Something magical on set, he says. So you're last, but definitely not the least. Okay, let me come here so that I can have time for you. Tell me about this initiative. Now, when you heard it, I'm sure that you were expecting. That's why you decided to, you know, what was your expectation? And now that you're going in there, what do you think will happen to you?
Okay, so first of all, when I saw it, I was a little bit skeptical because, I mean, it's actually the first time that we are going to have this in Africa. And so I wasn't sure if I should because I didn't even know I would be picked because I saw that it would be very competitive. But yes, like I was able to go through and all of that. So I'm expecting to learn a lot. I'm expecting to also have fun, a lot of fun in Nigeria. Mm-hmm. That's where we are going to, yeah. West Africa. But more importantly, to learn and network with other people, yes.
All right, so since you mentioned the fact that you're going to Nigeria, is it going to be your first experience?
In Nigeria, no. I've been to Nigeria before.
Okay, so
yes.
You're not going to be having the issues of what am I going to eat and all that?
I think still I'm going to have it.
So you're thinking
yes,
about that.
Yes, yes.
Okay, so what about you? Let me come back to my sports. So yeah. You can come here. What about you? You're nervous about, you know, what's going to be in that boot camp and all that. Are you nervous?
Yes. No. I'm not nervous at all. I mean, the only barrier that is going to be between us, it's not about creativity. Mm. Because as filmmakers, we all think alike somehow. The only barrier I'm looking at is probably language. Because we haven't, students
but
from...
They speak English, though.
Yeah, they speak English.
West Africa.
Exactly.
Okay, so maybe the Francophone countries.
Sure. So, because we're going to have other students joining us, and they'll be speaking their local dialects. And as a filmmaker, I'm sure that you need to be very vigilant, very sensitive, and then also learn other languages from the people that are around you. And then be able to also impact that in your film as well. Everything that goes on in our day-to-day life is what we put in our film.
It's what you put in your film. Tell me about how you're feeling about the experience of one year in Nigeria.
Okay, for now, and then even previously, we had already thought about it. Like, we've already dedicated time to do this. So we've made our mind up from this period in time, for 12 months, we are sacrificing to learn film. And to come back as improved people, not just to come back and come and sleep, but to come back and work for the industry.
So you've not thought about, you know, what you're going to eat. That's the least of your worry.
No, that's the least.
Okay,
for
a lady, I'm sure that's part of your worry.
Oh yes, yes. Making new friends. Mm-hmm. How are they going to react to you? Mm-hmm. And then for me, food.
Food, huh? Yeah.
Food. Yes. I'm very picky when it comes to food. You're very choosy.
But I'm sure by the time you come back, you start praising the Nigerian jollof of our hours. Eh?
Oh, well.
You never should try that.
Ghana jollof every day.
But you'll find
all
it
day.
There. You'll find it there. But I'm very excited for all of you, and I can only wish you well. And we hope that this journey you're embarking on will bring us some success, and we can't wait to see the champions you become in the few months to come. Thank you very much for speaking to us. The Deputy Minister of Tourism, Arts and Culture, Dr. Idi Zablim. And when we're in Lagos, spoke to you. Now we're in Ghana, and it's great to see you back home.
Good to see you.
Okay, so let's talk about first these four young ones who have been selected by MultiChoice Africa to go into a one-year workshop, sort of, to groom them for script writing, directing, production of movies. What do you make of the initiative?
Wonderful. I think that the future of any country, of course, you know, lies on the youth and the ones coming up. I told them in there that it's a big opportunity for them to take seriously. My understanding is that 600 applicants, you know, and, you know, they four came out as the ones that they finally selected. It's a big opportunity. When we were in Nigeria, we were told that this would actually, you know, allowed for people from all across the continent to come and stay in Nigeria for 1 year. And they will be taken through all the, you know, rigors of film production and all of that. So I am excited that, you know, we have a young generation that is also taking up, you know, and that tells you that there will be continuity in the industry, and we can always count on, you know, people like them. I hope that they will take this opportunity and run with it and come back with all the expertise that we need to enhance, you know, film production in Ghana.